Hello and welcome to another video here on the channel. Today we're playing Explorer and we're choosing Esper Control. So I've been talking trash a little bit about Esper Control, always saying that blue-white is just a better version of the deck. It has clean, easy mana. Nowadays blue-white has good removal with March, Portable Hole and Fateful Absence. So the necessity for black interaction should theoretically not be, you know, there. Warranted, but people have been talking about Esper, people have been praising Voidrend, people have been just saying good things about Esper. I'm a fan of Fatal Push myself, and then I stumbled upon this list here by Zach Allen, which is actually a Pioneer deck. He used it in the Pioneer tournament and NRG series. It's like a paper tournament series in the United States, where he used it to a top 8 finish. The only card that in the main deck that was different was Depopulate. Supreme Verdict, the better sweeper. It's legal in Pioneer. I hope we get it soon for Explorer 2 on Arena. I'll just replace it with Depopulate for now. You could also play something like Extinction Event, for example. But I want to just take as close as a list to what Zach was playing and just give it a ride, give it a spin. Basically, the question here is, the black removal worth the splash? Is it that good? Will it improve certain matchups? That is the question we are going to answer. I also changed a little bit of the mana base. The mana base included Shambling Wind, for example. That's not legal in Explorer. It's a man land from Battle for Zendikar. And yeah, I made some slight tweaks, gave the deck a little bit more utility lands because the mana base is already plenty good with all the duels. Notable exclusions are stuff like Jivai Disruption, Shark Typhoon, Dream Trawler, playing Absorb instead of Saw It Coming, just no Sensors, no Portable Holds, just choosing all the way black removal here, even with Blood Cheese first, which is interesting. Two copies of Vanishing Verse. That one I would consider very strong, but only two copies. Interesting too. Oath of Kaya is, I guess, a nice one. You have a decent amount of Planeswalkers. You gain some life, and it's okay. It's all right. I remember the time when it was legal and standard. You could use Small Teferi to bounce the Oath back to your hand. That was a nice value play to replay it and shoot something again. That was definitely nice. It shoots also Planeswalkers, which is cool. In the Mirror Match, you can maybe shoot down a Wandering Emperor or a Nazet or something. Fortzis in the deck, in the main deck. Very, very strong card overall. But in control decks, Fortzis is not as good as other cards usually. As in other decks. Because in control, you kind of want to gain tempo by the opponent casting their things, by them playing their things. So you can then depopulate or counter the stuff or use removal on their permanence that they spent mana on. Fortzis is a tempo negative play. You spend mana, you lose life as well, and you're going to take a card, but they haven't spent any mana. So if you're behind, if you're on a draw, that could be awkward. If you're playing against any sort of aggressive deck, Fortzis is often not the card you necessarily want. You just want to have removal and interaction and then a card that catches you back up, like Depopulate. Fortzis is going to be great in control mirrors and against combo decks. And it's just a solid card overall. But I think someone was also asking why in Demir Control I'm only playing one Fortzis. And it's just, you're trying to answer the opponent's threats after they spent the mana, not before they spent the mana. That's the trick. That's why you play stuff like counter spells, right? You can just counter everything. You don't need a card like Fortzis to take something that you can't counter, right? Like red-black midrange doesn't have counter spells. So they need Fortzis to take away a Teferi or something huge the opponent could have. But decks with blue cards with counter spells are less desperate for Fortzis. Sideboard, we got Ivagast, Malevolent Hermit as an anti-control card. I mean, this list is certainly interesting. For example, you see Dovin's Veto number 3 and 4. You see maybe up to 4 Mystical Dispute. And here instead you see the hermit, which I don't know what to think about that yet, but we'll try it out. And then we have Graveyard Trespasser, All-Star from Red Black Midrange, and Akaya down here comes in against decks with lots of one drops or Jun Food style of stuff. And two Noxious Grasp as well. Versatile card. All right. That is Esper Control. I think everything has been said. We have Yorion here. Plenty of playables allow us to play Yorion. And yep, that is the deck. Let's get into it. Oh, I didn't favorite it yet. Here it is. The season reset, so we are back at Platinum, climbing our way up. Hello, hello. Yeah, okay, sorry, I just checked the sound. We're on a draw. I have a fourth season of Fatal Push, I think I keep. Ascendant Spirit, okay. Da-da-da-da. Yep. Take away the protection. Oh. Yeah. So take the rattle chains and then push this in the upkeep, I guess. At least they don't get to attack then. Double Rafine's Tower, awkward already. Very awkward. Tap lands. I just play Nazir. Give some distraction. Now they have to decide what to attack. That's gonna be good. I mean, they will have to attack the Nazir, yeah. Because if they attack me, they don't get to draw a card. I still have much to learn. They have another obsession. I'll just play these two. I mean, we have push, 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 basically. Triple one mana removal, that's pretty good. It's... Maybe it's too aggressive. Should have done it in their turn. I just want to kill this now, you know. Rattle chains? No. Worked. Spectral Sailor, what do you got? Yeah, okay. Double Spectral Sailor. What you gonna do? Draw cards or attack with Faces Haven? It's interesting. Faces haven't quite good against my Teferi. Man, Supreme Verdict? Yikes. That would make a difference in this matchup, that is for sure. Okay. Alright. So I can play Teferi minus on a Shacklegeist. Then they would have to attack Teferi down. But I have a second Teferi. Could also play Teferi plus, but that doesn't really do anything. I could also play Oath of Kaya. Everything is kind of interesting. I think I'll just go with the Oath. It's like the Teferi number 2 will be good. This gains me life. I'm at 8. Alright. Maybe I punted. Maybe I wasn't supposed to do that. Because now I just die. 2-4 damage. That's pretty pathetic. Oh. But how do I prevent that? I mean, if I play Teferi, then they have to decide basically what they want to kill. Right, if I play Teferi minus, I'm gonna be at 9. They have to decide what they wanna kill. Sad. Such a good start. Blue Spirit stack is quite good against control decks, that's just how it is. Alright. Void Rend, huh? Uncountable. Doesn't go around Hexproof and slip out the back, though. Teferi's just not that good in this matchup. Davin's Vito neither. Absorb is kind of clunky. Alright. Draw 1 mana removal is the deal here. I mean, I have my mana. No one drop, that's nice. Agandro is perhaps good too. No 2-drop either. What the heck is going on here? I guess I could have returned Yorion there. Just playing it super safe. Just with a slip out the backup, or maybe. Yeah, Spell Pierce was the card I was thinking about. Interesting. Kind of just want to slam this. Rattle Chains is such an annoying card. It's just 2 mana, 2-for-1. It's any sort of removal spells. I've just killed this, I guess. Yeah, the Spirit's deck is just such a pain in the ass, honestly. I could just cast this and see what happens. They have a counter spell, they have a counter spell. Makes it simple. I wish I had a counter spell, I guess. With a rattle trains. Maybe you need absorb. They seem to have something here at least. I mean, I'm at 18. The more time I buy, the better. Maybe I'm playing too aggressive. Maybe I'm supposed to just do nothing. I think it's fine if they have rattle trains. Let me show you. They still have something to flash in.
I still have much to learn. Let your blade do the talking.
Yeah, this matchup's just tough. If you play, I mean, if you play, I mean, I played against this deck with Demir control as well. It felt rough. Any the blue spirit deck is very, very good against control or combo. Let that happen. Nothing. Brazen Borrower. Really? Makes me think they don't have Brazen Borrower. They have a packed hand. It's difficult to play against the spirit stack, just like the variety of things they can do, it's just so annoying. Just attack first, I guess. Maybe you're supposed to really play it slow, especially if they don't really pressure you. I could just wait with these Wandering Emperors until I can pay for the Geistlight Snare, for example. Are you saying you have a Geistlight Snare here? They clearly don't have a slip out the back. But see what's happening? They have to use like multiple counter spells now. Now I have the choice paying and then I use a Geistlight Snare to then fully counter me. Or I can just Odawara this Phantom. I'll just start off our end. Could get frisky with the hall here. Or I could play Yorian. But if they have another Lofty Denial, I'm gonna get punished. If they just have a Geistlight Snare, I'm gonna be fine. They usually only have two Lofties. I think Yorian should be pretty safe. They really need the second Lofty here, or multiple counter spells. They have multiple. Yeah. Okay. Trade, huh? What is gonna happen here? But if these blue-white decks have Supreme Verdict, just like they do in Pioneer, it makes this matchup a lot easier. Too much. I need to find something now. They're in the race. I need to find something. Yeah. Depopulate would be good. Fossils. Alright. I don't know. I mean, I could have played this slightly differently somewhere, somehow. I mean, you can tell me. Maybe I missed something completely. Could have played a little bit more patiently with my frets. But I don't know. That was just wasn't in the cards, really. I think that Blue Spirit stack is quite good against control. No matter how you slice it. I'm on the draw here. I think I can do better. Yeah. Sacred Foundry. Mardu Greasefang. Tenacious Underdog. I'll just kill it now. I don't want to run into a deadly dispute or something. Maybe it's not Mado Grease Fang. Maybe it's just some Mado mid-range deck. Holy shoot. Oh my god. Okay. Well, they're surely gonna take the Teferi. I don't know what's going on here. I guess I'll just kill off this Bone Crusher. Preserve my life total. What's happening to me? Feels pretty rough, what's happening. Oh well, oh well. I guess the good part is that they only can cast one of these. But they still have a Kroxa coming at me. Yeah, now they can cast two. Can either go for double Bone Crusher, yeah, or go for Chandra Bone Crusher. Interesting. I think that will just resolve. Nazet, Fatal Push. Sure. That was weird by the opponent, I'd say. I don't know if I agree with their play. Actually. Because now I didn't have to use the drown. I can have the drown for later. Do I shock myself? So this Kroxa also won't be able to come back. So they will just play Bone Crusher. They will play two Bone Crushers. Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So now I'm going to play Teferi minus on the Bone Crusher. I'm actually looking decent here. Oh my god, what is this bug? Could also plus the Teferi now. And just Vanishing Burst. That would bring me to 7. Sure. Then I can minus on the Kroxa with the Teferi if I don't find anything. Madu. So it's red-black, splashing for Showdown. It's good in the mirror match, I guess. It's a little bit of a slow card, though. Not a fan, honestly. I would rather just play Glorybringer, Sky Sovereign, something like that. What you gonna do? Exile that Memory Deluge? Attack the Teferi? Seems like a losing proposition, if you ask me. Don't make another move. To move quickly. I can actually attack the 7-7 here, or I can just play Yorion. Attack with the 7-7 is also kind of dangerous for my opponent. And I have an Absorb up. Seems pretty good. Dead 14. Perfect. All right. Okay, we got through that. It looked rough for a moment. I think the turn where my opponent. The turn where my opponent chose not to cast a Chandra was interesting because then I could Memory Deluge and find stuff and get back into this game. If they just play a Chandra there, I have to drown, then I can't Memory Deluge and can't find like that Naza to get going. I can just kill my opponent here. I really should have seen that coming. Let's take it back. Ta-da. Cool. Alright. Tenacious Underdog, Showdown, Kroxa. All right. Falsies, maybe? Bloodsheath first, Fatal Push. So I do want Gust. Hermit. I also had triple falsies, which is kind of outrageous. Graveyard Trespasser is decent against Kroxa and Underdog. Oath of Kaya, Bloodsheath first. Dobin's Vido. I like the Vido. I think it has enough targets. This is quite good against Bone Crusher. Doesn't, you know, cost me any life, gains me life. Just like I can see that Trespasser is decent, but I find it hard to cut anything. I guess it could be the Falsies after all. Just cut the Falsies for things that actually do something. It's also a top deck war situation. I don't know. Falsies is a difficult one to judge in a matchup like this. It has its moments, but I don't know how to say. Like this deck has answers to everything already. Like Void Rent kills literally anything my opponent can threaten me with. Vanishing Verse kills Chandra. Like I have answers to things. Interesting. So interesting. What do I discard? I think it has to be a 2-drop. Or the Wandering Emperor. I don't want to discard Memory Deluge, right? Maybe I should. Maybe I should. I have enough stuff going on that I don't need that effect immediately. Yeah. Maybe the depopulate isn't that good because of this thing. Well, now I really regret discarding the deluge. It's okay. I mean, they would have maybe Falsies it away anyways. They're missing land drops. These got a Fatal Push, it's still in their deck? What the heck? I'll just take some damage. Nothing. Five cards. Weird game. Not really pulling ahead because I discarded this Memory Deluge, which would have been really excellent this game to find me something I can pull ahead with and punish my opponent for not, yeah, for not hitting their fourth land. Vanishing Verse or Gust? Just gonna use Vanishing Verse here. Can also use Gust to exile this forever right here if I want to, but I need the Gust to kill the Kroxa.
Yep. You're going down.
You're going down. Nothing. Wow, that's huge. What's the hand? It's four spells. It just must be removal, I guess. Some sort of removal. Let's go. Angra's Rampage. Alright. That's a nice one against control. It's decent. There's another one. Sweet. That's interesting. I mean, Showdown of the Skulls is the big one here in this game. But countering this cooldowns command is probably worthwhile too. I can probably get through a Showdown with the cards I have. Another one. Alright. They're prepared for the Trespasser, huh? Yorion's quite good against them. 4-5 is a good stat line. So the question is though, do I want to fire off this Yorin, I guess? I guess I can Oath and then Flicker the Oath and shoot again. On the other hand, I can also just Memory Deluge. And then have an even crazier Yorin. No, I think I'm just going to go Memory Deluge here. I'll just go for it now. I have so many cards. I have an Aether Ghast. I want to get this game over with. Get some pressure on the board. That's one hell of a use of a Vanishing Verse. My opponent, that was a weird game. They just had a bunch of removal in their hand and they just overboarded, I guess, really. I mean, they had Vanishing Verses, they had Fatal Push still in their deck. They had these Angrath's Rampages, which, yeah, sure, they were okay in the spots, but that was like turn 10. They have to win against me. If we go to turn 10, I win, so... Especially if you're underplay, you want to have your deck filled with proactive cards, more or less, and only a few reactive ones. I'm underplay here. Risky. Risky hand. But good interaction early. I could easily just miss a couple land drops and be pretty unhappy. That was the wrong order. Jeez. I was so happy to see two lands that I just clicked through. That was definitely a misplay. Nemeth.
I am almost sad to see you go.
Four cards.
Remember your training.
No downside there compared to Supreme Verdict. It's Primal Growth. All right, you can kill my samurai all day. I mean, now I can shoot down this troll eventually, potentially, if I draw land. So I don't know if this is worth it, like making your troll susceptible to removal. From a sorcery speed remover.
I guess that's that. We must protect the people.
So they both trample. I'll just go Omen Aganjo here. Crazy how resilient this mono green deck is. We had so much removal and they're still doing just fine. But if they start playing around stuff, they give us so much time here. That's, you just can't play around anything anymore, I think, when you're the opponent here. You should just attack, in my opinion. Like, they were playing around Wandering Emperor there. Vanishing Verse. What's this? In a tournament, I wouldn't attack there, by the way, like in a paper tournament. But because it's arena and you see that the opponent doesn't have a company, I happily attack. With the Omen, I can make this push into kill anything, basically, by triggering Revolt. So that's 8 mana, alright. I can play the Fairy, draw a card, then kill off this troll. And still have Fatal Push. Gotta put a stop in the end step there. Attack for 6. Question is, do I kill this Llanowar Elf? No reason to. We have a blocker. Wandering Emperor is excellent against this mono green deck. Just Questing Beast is an annoying one. Questing Beast has a vigilance, quite good. Conceit. Yep. Alright, we have triple Aether Gust and Noxious Grass, so we're packing a lot of removal. Waltzies is not very good here. Kaya? Exile Elf, Pelt Collector, and Troll when it comes back. Might be okay. Otherwise, Trespasser or Waltzies. I mean, Nazareth is so la-la. Quartzies I really don't like. Trespasser? I don't know, their creatures are just bigger than Trespasser. Just take a card, yeah. Maybe I can hit something. Or hopefully I just won't draw the card, because it kind of sucks. But we're playing an 80-card deck, so... Okay. This Esper version definitely does seem pretty strong against creature decks. Like, it has a ton of removal and free sweepers in the main. I mean, Shape of Sanctuary. That's Vanishing Versable, which is nice. Ooze. Just Aether Gust to Ooze. This will be a 2-2. I just Vanishing Verse to Shape of Sanctuary and then play an Oath of Kaya, I think. This card is very good against Dimir. Blue White has Portable Hole in March. Doesn't really care. kill this off, this is gonna grow. If I kill this off, this is also gonna be a free free. It's just gonna be the Uzi, I think. They can exile the elf. Well, that was a mistake. They should have exiled the elf. Then this would have become a free free. I mean, it didn't matter, I guess. Kind of want to get rid of this pack leader. In the upkeep, maybe. Can draw it again if they want. All right. Interesting. Just do the same again. I guess so. Nah, you want to put it back again? Probably not. No, you do? What the heck? That's weird. I have a Yuri and an Elf of Kaya. Should have played, should have kept up the black land here. That was a punt. Because I can draw into Fatal Push. I mean, I guess those are like the two best cards I can have, and I have pressure, I have card advantage in a way. Why not keep those? Primal Growth here. Hello. And I will protect my people. I am almost sad to see you go. This matchup does seem pretty good. May your blade strike true. Ronas. Okay. So just using Noxious Grasp. Non-land permanent, huh? I guess I use this. Because of Lair. I can only kill with that. And this kills literally everything they have. I mean, it Might not kill a great henge, I guess. Alright. Pretty nice, pretty nice. I wonder if you can do a mix of the Demir control deck and the blue-white control deck. Which, this deck is kind of like a mix. But I guess what I'm envisioning is less planeswalkers, more black heavy, and then maybe a light splash or Teferi. Teferi is pretty good.
Teferi is pretty good. Oh, wow, really?
You only get these insights here on the Arno Schmidt channel. Teferi is pretty good, yeah. Yeah, so Teferi and then maybe Vanishing Verse, maybe Voidrend, just a light splash for Vanishing Verse seems very nice because it takes care of some very annoying things like the Shape of Sanctuary, Old Growth Troll and stuff like that, Chandra, that blue black hasn't the best tools to deal with otherwise. And Torrential Gearhawk, kind of like that card. I want to play with that one. Omen. I want to be mana efficient here. That's why I'm returning the Urien instead of the Omen. Instead of doing something with the Omen. Playing against black green fight rigging. Not playing a free drop here. Giving me so much time. So now I have two very good cards in my hand. Choose your poison. Four cards. Well, Great Henge comes to mind. Fight rigging doesn't quite do it yet. Like, do I kill this? Or do I not care? I could also Void Rend the Great Henge. But I'd rather have the Great Henge stuck in their hand, of course. On the other hand, if they just play another big creature, I'm sort of in the same spot next turn again. Not really getting out of that. Alright, I'll just kill this thing. And then we can cycle. So now the hope is that they just do not have another big thing and they're stuck with like great henches that they can't cast. Alright. Putting this on red, signalizing Valky. Interesting. I could just go for Wandering Emperor. Just push this Lanaway Elf. And then Wandering Emperor, make a 2-2. Then I can amass a little army. Pick a Numa. Oh, there's a Valky. Can take a Valky, a Scavenging Ooze, or a Lost Drug Beast. Take the Valky. Actually, don't mind that too much. I mean, it is annoying, but I will have 6 power next turn and a Yorian, so I can attack the Planeswalker down. Death Hive.
Anyone who harms my people must contend with me. Guards, to me.
Whoa, they just take the Yorian. I think I'm fine with that, honestly. Like, I have so much spot removal in my deck. Oh, and by the way, I didn't play the Goddess Shrine last turn, even though I had a land drop, because I didn't want to make it too obvious that I had the Wandering Emperor in hand. So if I play a tap Goddess Shrine, they're going to be like, wait a minute, you should just play Yorian there. It would really telegraph that I have a Wandering Emperor. Okay. I guess I got a little punished for not playing my Yorian after all. On the other hand, you cannot really say how this game would have gone the other way around. I'm pretty low on blue. I can't even... Let's do this. They have a hive over there. So I can find Voidrend. I don't want to expose my Deluge to the Hive. Their version is weird. They have Great Henge. Huh? They play a lot of cards that don't make sense. In my, like, that dilute their game plan in a way. Like, multiple Thought Seizers and pushes. It worked out kind of nice for them. Like, double Thought Seize was very good this game, and... Oh my god, this guy is good at this game, huh? Wow. Really good at this game. Wish I'd be so good. Nazad is pretty good against Great Henge. Just gotta find a removal for this Yorian, which we just found. I guess I can Nazad first. They have the hive though. Oh wow. And they also have skill. More skill than I do for sure. They have an incredible amount of skill. And a scavenger use for this memory deluge. Alright, I guess I got skill too. So I Voidrend. The Tybalt. I have to do that. Then they have this hive over there. And they have the Great Henge. And I have another. And they have a ooze. They can make it to a 7/7. So do I just depop right here, right now? Let them hive, let them kill my Nazad? And then Vanishing Verse the Great Henge? On a later turn? Hope they just draw a couple lands now. But so far, their draws have been incredible, so I don't have high hopes. They definitely messed up there. Could have played this pre-combat. Nah, I probably should just kill the Great Henge. Draw a card, I guess. What is going on right now? Teach me. Teach me. Teach me. Please teach me. Teach me. How? Teach me. I need to know how you are so good at this game. Wow. Noxious Grasp. They don't have that many green good creatures I need to kill. I already have the Aether Gust. What I like the least? Fortzies, Blood Sheath's first, maybe. Blood Sheath's first kills. Maybe I conceded a little early there. I could have killed this off, killed that, and then have a Teferi, tuck my own Teferi away. Maybe I conceded a little early there, huh? What the heck? So they're playing a bunch of Valkyries in a main deck, huh? Which makes the deck really shitty if they don't draw the fight rigging. But also increases their late game power level significantly. Which will be good against a deck like Esper Control, I guess. Especially if you rip Tybalt into Tybalt off the top. Almost back to back. Ay ay ay. I mean, Magic is a game of luck and skill, luck both. It's, you know, you win some, you lose some. It's how it is. Complaining too much about these very variables you don't have under control doesn't really do anything. It's not worth anybody's time. Ba 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 ba. Interesting. Why post combat? Kind of cool that I can enable revolt by just making a samurai. This is what you get for hurting my people. I think I just play Nazad here on an empty board. I think that makes sense to me. Push Nazad. So you think they have Rotting Reachosaur? I guess so. Can't really do anything against that. I don't have a Vanishing Verse. Wow, I'm so smart. My god. Yeah, I just needed some piece of interaction there. Counterspell, maybe. This is so good. This is so good. This is so, so good. This is so good. Now they have Tobin's video up as well. Wow. All right. Opponent should go into the lottery today, I think. I think we all agree on that. Absolutely. What the heck was that? All right, that was Esper Control, I guess. Yeah, well, decent deck. I don't know, like, it's hard to say if it's... I think it is... better against creature decks, because you don't really like the mana is fine and you get a little bit better removal overall. I would like to see more Vanishing Verse. I think the Fortsies I'm a little skeptical of, but yeah, overall I don't know. I find it difficult to say just after these 4 or 5 matches how and why Esper is better or not. Hard to say after that. Nonetheless, you don't always have to have an answer to a question like that, and it's an ongoing process. Yeah, this is Esper Control. If you are curious about the deck, if you wanted to see it in action, which I think a lot of people wanted to see some Esper Control and Explorer action, heard some requests, here you got it. Boy, that was the last, that last match was something else. Interesting fight rigging list too, lots of Valkyries. Maybe that's the way to go, but I feel like you're really making your deck a lot more inconsistent. Especially they also had Fatal Push in the main deck, they had Hive of the Eye Tyrant, which is a non-bow with Werewolf. Maybe they're not playing the Ambusher, the pack leader. Maybe they're just playing not the double green card and just be more combo oriented. While my black-green fight rigging list is more, you are basically like a mono-green stompy deck that also has this aspect of great henge and fight rigging. And that fight rigging list we just played against is more of a, hey, this is the thing. I'm doing the combo, I'm maximizing on that. Which, those are two different decks. My opponent really got rewarded because, I mean, their deck can do obscene things, I guess. I mean, the other fight rigging deck can also do obscene things. I play a Valky there too. But yeah, I mean, that was insane what they did. Jesus Christ, they really hit the lottery ticket. Anyways, enough complaining, enough about that. I hope you don't mind that too much, that I'm sometimes also a little bit of a whiny crybaby. We all are, and it is fine, but don't focus too much on that, because things that are outside of your control should technically not bother you whatsoever, especially if you play for money, for a tournament. It shouldn't bother you. You should be ice cold about these things, and you should just play, concentrate on the things you have under your control. And I think I'm lacking a little bit as of late when I'm playing these random, not random, but when I'm playing these ladder matches for not much, I guess. I do care, and I care enough to whine a little bit about it, about being unlucky or whatever. But yeah, I think it's a bad behavior and a bad habit. I should try to not commit more energy to that, and instead, because it is going to translate to tournaments as well. If I'm behaving like that in regular matches where I'm not playing for anything, this sort of behavior, this sort of habit of complaining about the opponent's luck is going to translate over, and it really should not matter. It really shouldn't. Well, back to the gym point. I didn't go to the gym yet. Maybe I should. Maybe I should power myself out, go and work out instead of sitting on my ass. And at that point, I might be so relaxed that I don't care and I just concentrate on what I have control over. All right. Thank you for listening to my TED Talk. Let me know if you like this little psychology mental game segment. Thank you for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe and like if you haven't yet. And see you next time. Bye-bye.